All right, now I'm ready to cut the slots in the bottom of my drawers for the drawer bottoms. Normally, I set my drawer bottoms a little closer to the bottom on furniture and stuff where they're just going to be holding clothes and what have you, but on heavy stuff like these drawers here that are going to just be loaded down with tools, I raise it up just a little bit. And so here are my two practice pieces that I cut that are going to have the Baltic birch plywood fit in here. And now you'll notice I'm going to be doing another combination technique. I'm going to use the table saw to cut the slots in all of these long pieces because I can cut all the way through without any problem. And it's just faster to have the dado set in there. But on the other ones with the pins in it, I can't cut all the way through or you're going to see them on the end, so I'll do that with the router. So I'll cut all these first and then I'll just set the router fence to match the tailed pieces or the pinned pieces and then cut them that way. But they're a lot shorter, so they're going to be easier to deal with. But let me show you my logic here on the way I laid these dovetails out in the first place. See, so all my pieces that when I cut these dovetails, I made sure that this I like to create a nice big shoulder here because I don't want tails too far out or pins too far out that can crack. But see, now I'm able to come in here and route my slot all the way in the bottom without interfering with this tail. I'm avoiding this completely. And so I'll be able to route my slot all the way down on both pieces of stock, the wides and the shorts. And so it's just a real nice way to do it, and you're not going to be able to see the slot, of course, because you know I'm not cutting through the tail. Now, if I was cutting through the tail, you'd see it on the end of the piece. So this is, you know, here's the piece. I set it up here like this. So I'm just going to run it across like that, and I have the height set at 7 millimeters. And so I'm going to cut all my interior pieces five millimeters more than the inside shoulder dimension. So it'll give me 2 millimeters of slop all the way around, or 4 millimeters, which is, you know, that's a nice amount to have some play. I don't want to bind it when I'm in, you know, putting the drawer in, the drawer bottom in. So let me just go ahead and cut all these. And oh, and here's the other thing. So, you know, you always want to make sure that you get all your orientation right when you do this. So you see, here are all my pieces. They all are all marked with the outs up. And then here are all the numbers, which denotes to me that they're the tops. So everything, I have all the tops. So this is the side that's going to run against the fence. So the slot's going to be cut in the bottom side here. So you just make sure you get all your orientation right. That's why your marking, it always helps that if you lay things out in a logical marked way, that so when you start running things across the table saw or use the router, you're not gonna make a mistake and route the wrong side. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut these. You don't need to see this. I'm just gonna pass them over the table saw and cut that dado in it, and then I'll move on to the router. I'll match the router to the slot that I cut on the bottom and just do that with the router. I'll show you that though. Table saw, you've seen that plenty of times already. I want to show you a trick for getting these router bits out of these collets. They can get stuck in here, and you can't put this in a vise because if you put it in a vise, it's just going to pinch it tighter. And you know, I got strong hands and I can't get this thing out of here without tearing my hand up. And so the last thing you want to do is start putting pliers, even if you wrap it with an old glove or something. And you know, why spend the trouble and do that? But a guy in a shop about 20 years showed me this little trick. So this is a scraper. It's actually an old Japanese saw blade, but any scraper that's thin enough will work. And you know, you're not going to damage the scraper, and you're not going to damage your collet or your router bit. And so you just look on your collet, and one of these collets is going to be the one that passes all the way through and is open. So here it is right here. So all you do is you just slip your scraper in. Here, I'll do it on this side so you can see it better. You just slip your scraper in like this and just push it down to where it separates it a little bit. There, it'll just come right out. So, I mean, it doesn't take much. I mean, all you're asking that to do is just barely flex it just enough to get it out. See? All I'm doing is just barely flexing that to get it in or out. So that just will save you so much trouble, but I just need to change router bits right now and use this quarter inch collet, and that dovetail bit is stuck in there. Perfect. So here's my stock that I'm going to route the drawer bottom slot in the bottom of it, but I'm gonna do what's called cut a blind dado. And that's why it's so important to learn how to use the router with the edge guide, because you know, a router table won't make this cut because you'd have to drop the material down onto the router cut and then be able to pull it off, because I don't want to cut all the way through, because otherwise if I cut all the way through, I'm going to see that on the end of my joint, and I don't want to see that on the end of my dovetail joint. So I need to plunge down in, cut, and then come back out. So what I've done is I've got the router in. I've got the quarter inch bit in the router, and it's going to just be one pass, because a quarter inch router bit in English is 6.635 millimeters, but this Baltic birch plywood is 0.6, and so it's going to leave just enough room without any trouble. So I just put the fence up here and then I lowered the bit down in here to depth, and then I adjusted the fence until the bit spun in here just exactly perfect without hitting the sides. So that's as close as we need it to be. So I'm gonna make this cut with the dust collector shroud off so you can see what I'm doing. So I just put this away, and again, oh yeah, back over here, I wanna say again, I've got my pieces oriented, so these are all insides and these are all tops over here. So as I take them off to route them, I'm going to take them off in this manner, so I've got everything oriented in the proper direction. And I've got a little mark on here too, because once I get going, I don't want to have to stop and try to think where I need to stop and terminate my dado. So let me just put this guy here. And of course, you know, I'm going to be using the power of my multifunction table once again. So that's all I need. I've got a little bit of overhang so my fence doesn't interfere with my table here. So whenever you use the router and the edge guide and you're doing an interior cut, now this is so crucial. I should have flashing stars and sirens going off and all kinds of stuff going across the screen. The router bit is spinning this way. So as you're cutting this way, like this, the router bit is pulling the fence into the work. Now if you were cutting an interior cut and you tried to push the router back against it, the router would buck and jump out and make a mess of your work like you cannot believe. So as long as you're making your cut in this direction, and if you have to do it in multiple passes, I'm not going to try to do this to depth in one pass. So you'll see I'll plunge down, make part of it, and I'm going to come up, but I'm going to relieve the bit all the way out of the workpiece before I come back and start again. Now if I tried to pass that bit down in the workpiece, it's going to catch and it's going to buck and it's going to make a mess. Not only is it going to make a mess, but it's going to be dangerous, and it's going to be hard on your router, hard on your bits, and it's going to turn the project you're working on into mush. So let me put some plugs in. Like I said, I don't have my dust collection shroud on right now because I really want you to see what's going on here. Let me see if I should even, yeah, let me come up even a little bit closer so you can see this initial plunge cut down into. that's all there is to it. Perfectly clean, perfectly smooth. You know, this isn't that critical. I know I'm, you know, beyond by my distance pretty easily. Here, let me do another one so you can just see, you know, once you get this set up, how just you can just get on with it and just keep moving. As long as you pull this way, the spin of the router bit is pulling the fence into the workpiece. And so as long as you don't have to apply death pressure, but as long as you apply good, steady, uniform pressure, you know, not so much that you're creating friction where you're not going to allow your fence to slide freely against your workpiece, but as long as you're providing, you know, some good backing pressure just to keep the fence aligned, you'll cut things as perfect as your edge is. So it'll just follow whatever your edge is. So it's a real good way to do it, fast. But like I said, it'd be very difficult, if not impossible. You can't do that on a table saw, and you can't do it on a router table. So how else are you gonna do it? You're gonna do it like this. So those are the shorties. Pull away and give a little better perspective now. So you'll see me make one cut, and then I'm gonna let the router bit raise up out of the work as I bring the router back again.